P&G and many other Fortune 100 companies are seeking out candidates from this particular university's MQM program. Yes, you heard that right. In the words of David Taylor, executive chairman of P&G, the Duke MQM and MSQM programs develop data analysts with broad business perspective, strong technical expertise, and deep command of business communication for whom Fortune 100 companies go crazy for. So today we are going to talk about this particular program. Welcome or welcome back to the channel. This is Ananya and today we will explore Duke Fukua's MQM Business Analytics or Masters in Quantitative Management Business Analytics program. 97 students reporting, making up the reporting rate 80%. The average starting salary is around $90,000 with an average signing bonus for a few students amounting to $7,900 respectively. If we talk about selected employers and titles by track, in finance track, the positions were of senior business analyst, financial analyst, IT risk analyst, etc. in companies like Amazon, American Express, Deloitte, ZS Associates and so on. In forensic track, in the position of staff accountant, financial analyst, audit associate, etc. in companies like JP Morgan, Chase, Walmart, etc. And then in marketing track, in positions like data scientist, business intelligence analyst in companies like Uber, Walmart, Brain Labs, followed by strategy track in positions of data engineer, human resources analyst, advanced analyst manager in companies like Bank of America, Dell, KPMG, LLP, Mastercraft, and so on. As per the QS University World Ranking 2025, MQM program of Duke Fukua is ranked number 7. Under top business master ranking in business analytics program. What about the class profile? 2023 class profile says an average age of 23, an average work experience of 23 months with women 135, GPA 3.62, GMAT 651 to 760, GRE 152 to 166. Countries represented are 27, undergraduate institutions represented 152. Isn't that great? For students beginning their program in the July cycle, the tuition cost is $83,500. Medical insurance and other fees is $6,600, followed by educational supplies of $800, then an estimated living expenses for approximately $30,000. Total cost of attendance, $120,000. But worry or not, there are numerous opportunities that will help make your Fukua education a reality. All applicants are automatically considered for merit-based scholarships. There are numerous federal and private loans for US citizens and permanent residents and even international student loan program, which requires no co-signer for all international students, and numerous other scholarships and fellowships to make your admission super easy. So in curriculum, your program starts in July with a launch experience that prepares you for the curriculum. The rest of the experience is organized into 5-6 week terms. You get to explore a selection of core courses available to you. Now the foundational courses in business include data analytics courses, finance track courses, marketing track courses, risk track courses, and strategy track courses. Now starting in the second term when available and when space permits, you will be able to take courses specific to other track selectives to give you more breadth in analytics beyond your area of expertise. The analytics program culminates in a capstone project, a 6-week intensive project in which teams of students partner with faculty advisor and an organization to solve a specific problem utilizing all analytics techniques learned. The capstone is designed to give students the opportunity to utilize the domain-specific tools developed throughout the program in a real-world environment in which they are exposed to the challenges inherent to modern data environment. For eligibility, you must have earned or expected to earn a bachelor's degree in science, technology, engineering, mathematics, business, economics, or an equivalent quantitative major by the start of the program. Your degree must be from an accredited college or university. If you have more than 3 years of postgraduate work experience, either paid or unpaid, including volunteer positions, part-time work, and internships, you have to contact Ben Boatwright, our MQM Business Analytics Admission Counselor, to review your eligibility. As for the admission requirement, the process is simple. After research, you fill the application form that has to decide to apply for the program, followed by the submission of few required documents which will be told to you, followed by an interview if you are cracking it. If you will be accepted into the program, submitting a non-refundable security deposit will lead to your admission. So the documents required are Number 1. Transcripts. Legible, scanned copies of all transcripts are required for each college or university you have attended. Transcripts must include your name, name of the institution, each course taken, and the grade received, and also the degree received and date confirmed. Followed by number 2, questions and essays. The admissions committee wants to learn about your personal and professional motives through one shot. Answer questions and 2 essays as part of your application. You are required to answer carefully, fully and concisely without repeating the question in the document you upload. The questions are of required short answer question. You have to answer both essays in 750 characters at most. Why did you select your preferred track, finance, marketing, risk, strategy? And what are your immediate career goals after completing the MQM Business Analytics program? Next, a long-form essay question, which is random things about yourself, and then your response to as a question should be no more than 350 words, describing how would you plan to engage inside or outside of the classroom and how your unique perspective, experiences and passions will add to the MQM community. You can also hand in an optional essay if you feel the circumstances of which the admission committee should be aware of. Next is one-page resume, and then you submit your required resume electronically within the online application system. Your resume should include full-time and part-time employment, volunteer work, internships, and all your education data. Next is letter of recommendation. One letter of recommendation is required and should come from someone who knows you in professional contacts, such as a supervisor at an internship or place of employment. You may not submit more than one recommendation. Next is the test scores, GMAT, GRE, SAT and ACT scores. One of these test courses is required for application to be considered complete and to receive an admissions decision. The IELTS or TOEFL test score is not accepted, so your English abilities will be reviewed based on written essays and application and verbal proficiency in the interview. Then you pay a $125 non-refundable application fee payable by Visa or MasterCard. Next up is your interview. Interview invitations will be extended after careful review of your application materials, which will occur mostly via video conference conducted by Fuqua staff, alumni or selected students who will ask you a variety of questions about your educational background and personal interests, appropriate attire in business casual, non-US applicants for you specifically. You have an additional application requirement and instruction, such as the transcripts, diploma and academic records, all should be in English and certified by an appropriate university official. The 3-year bachelor degree is equivalent to US bachelor degree for you. The ESL test courses are not accepted, for English language proficiency is as discussed above. International students, what about your visa? So if applicable, visa application information will be included in your admission packet along with specific deadlines for submission. Visa processing can take up to several months to complete, so it is critical you apply no later than round 2 to ensure that you are able to join the program. So this sums up the entire details about getting into Duke Fuqua's MQM program. Well, this makes me wonder, what makes quantitative management different from business analytics that is provided at UCLA? So do check out our UCLA video to explore and differentiate between the two programs. So that was all for today's video. See you next time. This is Ananya signing off.